Good morning. It's great to have the second grade with us here today. Very exciting to see all of you. I haven't seen you guys for a long time, so this is nice. It's also fun today because we have altar servers back on the altar, so things are starting to feel a little bit like last year. So if everybody could please join me in praying our vocations prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd. You know each of us, and you call us by name to serve the faith. Help us respond generously to your voice. Give courage and guidance to those you call to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, single life, and sacramental marriage, so they may respond wholeheartedly and serve devotedly. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. If everybody could please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Good morning, everybody. God has given us the gift of a new day, and so may we greet it with thankfulness. May we come here and pray our hardest. May we enter into this Mass, and through being here, help us. Help us to appreciate all that Jesus has done for us out of love for us, how he offered himself for our sakes, and how we share in what he has done. He's conquered sin. He has defeated death. He was raised, and we recognize him as the way. And for the times that we haven't then always reflected that by our thoughts, our words, or our actions, we definitely do rely on your mercy, but have hope through that which we share here, that you remind us of your longings for us to have abundant life through him and with him and by the Holy Spirit that works in all of our lives. And so it's in that way that we come humbly to this holy place. It's here that we gather as one family and pray all that we share. Lord, may we look to you and always learn from your example of obedience and love. Lord, have mercy. Lord, may we forever proclaim who you are in our lives by how we live. Christ, have mercy. Lord, as we come and receive that which we do here, through word, through sacrament, may it help us all to live the day the best we can. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring all of us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, perseverance in obeying your will, that in our days, the people dedicated to your service may grow in both merit and number. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Numbers. from Mount Hor, the children of Israel set out on the Red Sea to bypass the land of Edom. But with their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from Egypt to die in this desert where there's no food or water? We're disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people seraph serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. And then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray that the Lord to take the serpents away from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole. And whoever looks up at it after being bitten will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it up on a pole. And whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord. O God, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you. O God, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you. O Lord, hear my prayer and let my prayer come to you. Hide not your face from me in the days of my distress. Incline your ear to me in the day when I call. Answer me speedily. O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you. The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the desolate and not despised their prayer. O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you. Let this be written for the generations to come, and let his future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height, from the heavens, he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die. O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you. May Almighty God be in our thoughts. May Almighty God be in our lips. May Almighty God be in our hearts. Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I am going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin. Where I am going, you cannot come." So the Jews said, "Is he not going to kill himself? Is he? Because he said, 'Where I am going, you cannot come.'" And he said to them, "You belong to what is below. I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. That is why I told you that I will die in your that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins. And so they said to him, who are you? And Jesus said to them, what I have told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you in condemnation. But the one who sent me is true. And what I have heard from him, I tell the world. They did not realize what he was speaking to them of the Father. And so Jesus said to them, when you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father has taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him. Because he spoke this way, many came to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. I am pretty sure that if we went around this church this morning and especially asked our adults that are here, I would be willing to say that almost every one of them would be able to say that their second grade in school was probably one of the most exciting. Right? And it is. It is because of what you guys have going on. It is because what you are preparing for, what you receive, it has to do with how you guys have been trying to put forth your best efforts and getting ready for first reconciliation, as we took part in that last fall, had your very first reconciliations, and that was a beautiful day. And I saw how much you celebrated that God loves you on that day. And then as we've had First Holy Communion spread, some of you received it in the fall and some of you are going to receive it this spring. It has to do with getting closer to God. And it has to do with coming to celebrate who Jesus is. And what we find in life is that no matter how old we are, every one of us has many, many opportunities for us to seek and to grow and to persevere and to come to discover who Jesus really is. And that's what makes this such a perfect time, as we've all just heard, as we're so close to entering into Holy Week next week, and then celebrating Easter after that, it takes us right back to being grateful for who we proclaim Jesus to be, as our Savior, as the one who loves us, as the one who laid down his life for us, for his friends, as the one who accepted death on the cross. And he did that because he wanted to fulfill. He wanted to carry out his mission. He wanted to do all that he could so that we would be invited, that we'd be invited to share in his glory, that we would be able to be a part of his body. And that is... that is such a gift. And so as we can pray this morning, as we all have heard As we sang when we began, help me to hear, Lord. Help me to hear, Lord, what you're asking of me. And what God is asking of us in return, you know, is to look to Jesus, his son. And what he's longing for us to do is to learn from his example and what Jesus did so willingly was he desired to live a life and to please his Father, as we all should. And so, as we can start off a new day, as we can celebrate all that we do, as we can come together as children of God, may we recognize what Jesus wants us to be assured of. And that is that he's with us and that he longs for us all to have abundant life through him and with him and by his Holy Spirit, his Holy Spirit that does great things in our lives when we open ourselves up to seeking to let that Holy Spirit be reflected. We celebrate who we are as children of God. We celebrate that we're children of light. And so may we be reminded as we share all that we do that we're called to, with every day of our lives, to nurture our souls, to seek to try to make them more pleasing to our God. And through doing so, it makes us all ready for heaven. And so may we be grateful that God loves us so much that we can have no greater gift than we could ever hope for, pray for, ask for than our Savior Jesus Christ, who raised himself, who was raised on the cross, that we may have and share in his way and have eternal life. Amen. And rising up and joining together as one family in faith, we come before you now, O God, and we place our needs, asking you to hear us by saying, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray on this day that we all, as your children, as your church, that we may strive to make the most of every day as a way for us to grow in our faith and to grow in holiness and to learn always and forever from Jesus. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may forever be grateful for all that Jesus has done for us by rising from the dead and longing for us to share in his life, his glory, forever. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving that we can wake up to a new day, that you will help us to see the many, many blessings that we may be people that who do not complain, but rather recognize the many opportunities that we know we are given to live and to love. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are faced with much, those that endure, those that have already begun this day feeling its difficulties, that you'll see to it that there are people around them that care for them as your true instruments of your peace. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always give witness to the sacredness of all life, from the moment of conception all the way through natural death, that we may speak and often be the voices of those voices that go unheard. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for all that we know we have and share, as a part of St. Patrick's Parish and St. Patrick's School, that we may continue to try to do our part to seek to bring Jesus to one another. For this we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all those who've died, gone before us, that they may share fully in your life and your kingdom of love forever. For this we pray to you, Lord. Almighty God, We come as your children. We turn to you. We trust in you. We ask you. May these prayers be received, for we always ask them through Jesus, for we proclaim him as the way, the truth, the life. We look to him and love him forever as Savior and brother. We know he shall one day take all of us to you, to where you live forever and ever. Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his church. We offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice of our conciliation, that being moved by compassion, you may both pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since the wondrous powers of the cross, your judgment of the world is now revealed in the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and the saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread into his hands and he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples and said, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life, this chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us even worthy to be here today in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, with George Archbishop, with the bishops, the clergy, the religious, and the entire people that your son Jesus has gained as your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all those who've died in your mercy. And this morning we do remember Curtis Stetcher. Welcome him and all into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin, Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, St. Patrick and all the saints who've done your will throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And brought here this morning, taking to heart, reflecting deeply upon the gift of who Jesus is, we pray the words that he taught us, our Father in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance to your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever." Amen. The peace of the Lord be with all of you. And now, with keeping social distancing, but definitely as a sign of reverence for each other, if we'll give a bow and a hand over our heart or a peace sign, okay? Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. You say your word, my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. We ask that we start with this section and this section and this section and then move into this section and this one as well. So if anyone is here that has a need to receive by the tongue, we ask that you wait till the very end. And if you would be by the baptismal font, I will make sure and bring that to you. Thank you.
You alone are holy, you alone.
And we have just a couple of announcements this morning. And the first one is, I hope everybody has a special day, but Mrs. Thompson, it's her birthday today, so we hope you have an special birthday as well. Enjoy. You know, in about an hour, we're going to be able to celebrate the life of a wonderful, wonderful man, Dwight Peterson, and I'm sure that many of us can remember many times because he was a frequent here. He was here lots of times for daily mass. One of the things that might help you to remember him is because most of the time with his jackets, he always had Mickey Mouse on them. He loved Mickey Mouse. He always thought Mickey Mouse makes everybody happy, and he wanted to try to do that. There's lots and lots that we're grateful from his life. You know, he spent over 50 years being a counselor, starting out at Boys Town and working with juveniles throughout his whole life. And he dedicated himself towards helping, and especially worked for and took on many, many kids as his own. And so he was a great man, and he's been a gift around here at our parish as well. We remember him, and we pray for all of his family. And I think that there's lots that I know that I want to be reminded by his life, because he did find so much happiness. He loved everyone. He had that gift of just wanting to. He saw how important it was to love one another, and he put it to practice in many, many ways. So I think we can recognize that we're blessed to have people around us that reflect that, as he has for so many. May he rest in peace. And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that ever seeking what is divine, we may always be worthy to approach these heavenly gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. O God, who chose to show mercy, not anger, to those who hope in you, grant that your faithful may weep as they should for the evil that they have done, and so merit the grace of your consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Somebody's knocking at your door. Somebody's knocking at your door. Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door. Knocks like Jesus. Somebody's knocking at your door. 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 Oh, sinner, why don't you answer? Somebody's knocking at your door.
Awesome. For anyone who is planning on